Welcome to everyone. Previous class, we discussed types of soil. According to Indian Council of Agriculture Research, set up after the independence 1953, there are 8 types of soil in India. Okay, according to Indian Council of Agriculture Research, set up in 1953, there are 8 types of soil in India. There are alluvial soil, black soil, wet soil, laterite soil, forest and mountain soil, arid and desert soil, saline and alkaline soil, finally peaty and marshy soil. There are 8 soils in India. Okay. During the ancient period, there are 2 types of soil. One is Urvara and another one is Ushara. So what is Urvara and what is Ushara? As we discussed already, fertile soil, it is called as Urvara. Non-fertile soil, it is called as Ushara. Okay. So, soil is very important to the agriculture crops. Okay. To cultivating the crops, soil is very important. So, based on the topography, there are 8 types of soil in India. In today's class, we are going to discuss soil degradation. Soil degradation. One of the important problems in India is soil degradation, which means soil problem. It is losing their fertile due to the soil erosion or any other natural agent. It is losing their fertile. Okay. So soil degradation is one of the important problems in India. According to 2015 report, Indian Institute of Remote Sensing, Indian Institute of Remote Sensing. So what is remote means? Long distance. So long distance is called as remote. Okay. So according to 2015 census, Indian Institute of Remote Sensing, in our country, the soil erosion that occurred in India, 147 million hectares. 147 million hectares. Okay. 147 million hectares. We are losing our soil. Okay. Due to the soil erosion. Due to the soil erosion, we are losing our soil. 147 million hectares. Okay. 1 hectare equal to 2.47 acres. 2.471 acres. 1 hectare equal to 2.471 acre. So in India, 147 million hectare losing due to the soil erosion. Okay, due to the soil erosion. The main problem of Indian soil are soil erosion. So what is soil erosion? For example, this is soil. Okay, so this is soil due to the heavy rainfall. Due to the heavy rainfall, so this soil, the fertile will take from one place to another place. Okay, because from soil above only are the fertile. Fertile means quality of the soil, all the minerals, most of the minerals available surface of the soil. So due to the heavy rainfall, this fertile will take from one place to another place. It is called as soil erosion. So types of the soil erosion, sheet erosion. So sheet erosion means when rainfall, it is taking the soil, remove the soil, is called as sheet erosion. So types of soil erosion is one type of sheet erosion. For example, this is land area. When the rainfall, okay, due to the rainfall, so this soil, it is taking from one place us to another place. It is called as sheet erosion. And next one is rill erosion. So this rill erosion, it is creating the small channel. Okay, so this land area, it is creating the small channel due to the heavy rainfall. So this soil moving from another place, so it is here creating the small channel, is called as rill erosion. And next one is gully erosion. So this gully erosion also like same type, it is removing the some deep of the area. Here it is small channel, here it is removing the some soil, it is called as small channel. Again some deep area. Okay, again it is removing from the deep area, is called as gully erosion. And next one is rare end erosion. So this rare end erosion, it is taking from, we can see the mountain area. Okay, so this side also mountain and both side also covered by the mountain. In the center area is flow of the water. Center area is flow of the water, is called as rare end and badland erosion. We can see in the mountain area, so both side is covered by the rocks and the center we can see the flow of the water. And next one is degradation of soil. Okay, so soil degradation, the reason is degradation of soil. Water logging, so water logging when the rainfall absent of the channel. Okay, absent of the ill drainage, when the rainfall absent of the ill drainage, this water storing the particular place, the water is storing the particular place. So due to the heavy rainfall, this salt water came to the surface area. Salt water came to the surface area, it is called as water logging. And saline and alkaline, saline and alkaline, as we discussed already, the types of the soil. So from root, okay, like root, from root take the soil from subsoil to top soil. Okay, the root take the water, the root take the water from subsoil to top soil. Okay, due to the capillary action, with help of the capillary action, it is taking from subsurface to the top soil. It is saline and alkaline problem. And salt flat, salt water, it is moving to the flat area. And some types of the soil are different erosion. So different types of the soil facing the different erosion. So we want to be conserve the soil. We have to be conserve the soil. Soil erosion, we should conserve the soil. So method of conservation and management of soil. Afforestation, so what is afforestation? Plant more trees. Okay, plant more plants or trees, it is called as afforestation. And constructing dam and barrages, constructing dam, because the flow of water, what will happen? Soil erosion, it will happen, the soil erosion. So if we build any dam or barrages, what will happen? So this water flow in the dam. Okay, flow in the dam. So avoid the soil erosion, so that we should construct the dam or barrages. And prevention of overcrashing. So grass, you know well what is grass. So prevention of overcrashing. Okay, overcrashing. And improve the method of agriculture practice like contour method. Okay, I have some agriculture method like contour method. Contour method, rotation of crops. Then contour bunding. Strip cropping. Planting of shelter belts. So this all the method we can conserve the soil. For example, contour method. So contour method, we can see the hills area. Okay, we can see the hills area. For example, perpendicular to the slope area. Perpendicular to the slope area. So here it is possible for the soil erosion. So using this contour method, so this perpendicular to the slope area, we can change to the cultivation area. We can change to the cultivation area. Okay. So that for this method, we can use like plant some crops again as some way, and again we can change to the plant some crops. So this method is called as contour method. And rotation of crops. Same area, we are cultivating more than crops. Same area, cultivating the more than crop is called as rotation of crops. Next one is contour bending. So this method, using the slope of elevation. The slope of elevation, we are using some, okay, we are using some this contour method. Contour method. So contour method, like we can stop the soil erosion. Using this method, we can stop the soil erosion. And next one is strip cropping. So using this strip cropping, we can use like a strip. Okay, change the agriculture land like a strip method. And planting of shelter method. Using this method, planting of shelter method, we can plant more trees, avoid the wind. Because due to the wind also has some soil erosion. So this method, we can plant many trees. So we can stop the blowing of the wind. We can stop the blowing of the wind. So this method, we can conserve the soil. Using this method, we can conserve the soil. After that, using some technology of sustainable agriculture, using some different conservation method of better soil management. Using some better soil management, we can avoid the soil erosion. Okay. So importance of soil erosion, food and agriculture organization. Food and agriculture organization celebrating every year from 2014 December 5. Okay, from 2014 December 5, every year we are celebrating the World Soil Day. Okay, celebrating the World Soil Day. So, Food and Agriculture Organization celebrated World Soil Day 2020. The theme of World Soil Day. The theme of World Soil Day 2020. Keep soil alive and protect soil biodiversity. It is the theme of World Soil Day, December 5, 2020. So every year we are celebrating the World Soil Day. December 5, every year we are celebrating the World Soil Day. Okay. Next, we are going to discuss irrigation, the method of irrigation. So watering of agriculture plant. So what is irrigation? Watering of agricultural plant. Okay. Because most of the family, they depend on the agriculture. So you know very well, watering of agricultural land with the help of irrigation method. Okay. Using this irrigation method, watering of agricultural land through artificial means is called as irrigation. Through artificial, like canal, bore well. Okay. For example, so this, using this artificial, it is called as irrigation. Okay. Watering of agricultural plant. Watering of agricultural plant through artificial, it is called as irrigation. So being the hot country, India is a hot country, some seasonal time and irregular rainfall. Okay, in our country we are facing the irregular rainfall. It always need irrigation to carry out agricultural activity during the dry period. Okay, so you know, well, India is a hot country, moderate hot country and irregular rainfall. So we need the irrigation method. So we need the irrigation method doing the agriculture. Okay, doing the agriculture, we need the irrigation method because of irregular rainfall and India is a hot country. Okay, sources of irrigation. In India, there are different types of the irrigation are depending upon the topography. Topography means land area. Topography. The topography means land area. So in India, based on topography, soil, rainfall, then availability of surface or groundwater, nature of river, whether perennial or non-perennial. Perennial river means all the days we are receiving the water is called as perennial river. Non-perennial, only the seasonal time we are receiving the water is called as non-perennial. So based on perennial or non-perennial, requirement of crops. Okay, needed requirement of needed for the water, crops, etc. So this is main concept of the sources of irrigation. The main sources of irrigation used in different part of country. Okay, so different part of country you are following the irrigation method. From that, the important irrigation method of canal irrigation, canal irrigation, well irrigation, tank irrigation. Okay, in India, different places we are following the canal irrigation, well irrigation, tank irrigation. Okay, canal irrigation in India following the people 24% and well irrigation we are following the people 46%. Tank irrigation we are following only 3% because in this area the people are very less and doing the agriculture also very less. And canal irrigation, 24%, canal irrigation 24%, other well irrigation, some other well irrigation 16%, and some other sources, some other extra sources getting the water is 11%. So total 100%. So this is all the method we are taking, we are using the irrigation, watering the agriculture. First we are going to discuss canal irrigation. Canal irrigation. It is second most important irrigation in our country because 24% canal irrigation depend on 24%. Tube well irrigation, well irrigation depend on 46%. So it is second important irrigation in our country. Canal irrigation, second important irrigation in our country. So canals are effective sources of irrigation in our low level area. So canals, it is one of the effective sources of irrigation, low level area and plain area, fertile soil, perennial source of water and extensive common area, water logging area. So in this area, this canal irrigation, it is very very important. Okay, it is one of the important source of irrigation, low level area, plain area. So this canal irrigation, we can follow the low level area, plain area, canal area, then fertile area, deep area. So most of the area we can follow this canal irrigation. So this canal irrigation, there are two types. One is inundation canal, inundation canal, and another one is perennial canal, perennial canal. So inundation canal, what is inundation canal? So this water is taken out directly from the rivers without making any kind of porridge or dam. Such canals are useful for the diversion of the flood water from the river and remain operational during the rainy season. So this inundation canal, so this water taking from the river directly to the agriculture area. They are not using any porridge or any dam. Clear? So this inundation canal inundation canal taking the water from the river directly to the agriculture area. For example, you know, well, delta region. So during the flood time, what will happen? So this channel, will get excess of water, and this water will go to the residency area. Okay, so through the channel, so this excess of water during the flood time, it will move to the residency area. So avoid this problem from the river directly taking the water to the agricultural land. It is called as inundation canal. Clear? So this area only will get the water from the seasonal time. Okay. So this type of canal will get the water only from the seasonal time. When heavy rainfall, during heavy rainfall, flood time, we are getting the water with the help of this inundation canal. Okay. Next one is perennial canal. So these are developed from perennial river by constructing barrage to regulate the flow of water. As we discussed already, perennial river and non-perennial river. So perennial river all the time is getting the water, available the water. So this perennial river all the time available of the water. So this dam constructing the barrage. So this perennial canal constructing the barrage to regulate the flow of water. They control the flow of water. In North India side, 60% of the people depend on the perennial canal. Okay, North India side, we are in South India. North India people, 60% of the people for agriculture depend on perennial canal. So here availability of the water 24/7. Okay, so here they are constructing any dam or barrage. Okay, dam or barrage, and regulate the water flow. Regulate the water flow and using the water for the agriculture land. So 60% of the water, 60% of the people from North India are depending the perennial canal. Here. Next one is well irrigation. So this well is old or tough. It is usually vertical excavated in the earth for bringing the ground water to the surface water. So this well irrigation, you know, well, more well. Okay, any other normal well. So this all you can see, this well irrigation. So this old or tough, this water taking from, to bring the surface area. So taking to the surface area, bringing the ground water to the surface area. With help of this bore well or well. Okay. So well irrigation, it is one of the most important sources of irrigation in India. It is cheap and dependable. So most of the people, dependable and popular source of irrigation in our country. Mostly dry area, non-perennial area, the people are depend on well irrigation. So well irrigation, it is one of the unavoidable in the region of low rainfall area. Okay. So this well irrigation, taking the water from ground area to the surface area. So this well irrigation, the people are following the low rainfall area, and it has become very essential one. The canal and tank irrigation are available. So that is one of the essential one where the canal and tank irrigation are not available. Okay. So this well irrigation, the types are open well and tube well. So well irrigation, the types was open well and tube well. So tube well means bore well. Open well means normal the well. So where it is availability of the surface of the water, we can take this open well. Okay, we can take this open well. So availability of surface of the water, we can take this open well. So not available surface of the water, so we can go with ground water with help of this tube well, which means bore well. Okay. So open well. So this type of irrigation is widely practiced in the area where ground water is sufficiently available. They are using the open well. So the area Ganga Plain, Delta region, Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, and part of Narmada and Tapti, we are following this open well. Okay. So this open well availability of ground water is sufficient. We are getting sufficient of the ground water. So mostly it is possible for this open well river area. Okay. For example, Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari, Mahanadi, here Narmada, Tapti. Okay, Narmada, Tapti. So in this area it is possible for this open well. Okay, next one is tube well. So tube well are developed in the area of low water table. So it is not available 100 feet, 1000 feet, 5000 feet. So it is not availability of the low water table and sufficient power. Electricity, it is very important. And soft subsurface geological area. Have any hard rocks means it is not possible to tube well. Okay. Only the fine rock. Okay. It is possible to get fine rock and electricity. And electricity also is very important for the tube well or bore well. Okay. So no water table. So this where it is not available of the ground water. So we are going to the tube well. So no water table with help of the bore well. We are getting the water to the surface. Okay. Here what is important? Electricity and fine rock geology. Fine rock geology. Then only we can put the walls. Okay, any old rock it is available, it is not possible to get the tube well. So this also not availability of the water, ground water in that area, we are using this tube well. Okay, so this area mostly they depend on Gujarat, Maharashtra, Punjab, Madhya Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. So in this area we are following the well irrigation. Okay. So today class we have discussed conservation of the soil, soil degradation, irrigation method. What are the types of irrigation? Canal irrigation, well irrigation and tank irrigation. Among them today class we have discussed canal irrigation and well irrigation. Next class we will discuss tank irrigation. Okay. Next, read and learn the following. The question, distinguish between alluvial soil and black soil. Next question, define irrigation. So this is your home test, your convenience number. I hope you understood this session very well. Thank you. Have a nice day.